Well, good morning, everybody. This is Monsignor Woy and
Rev Kev.
And if you're wondering where we are greeting you from today, this is the chapel in the rectory where we come to pray and the other priests. So we know many of you have not seen this chapel, so we thought we would offer our reflections from here today. Well, you know, when I get up in the morning, one of the things I try to do in my prayer is thank God for all the blessings that He has given to me. And one of the blessings that I thank God for today was my friends, especially in this time when we can't, you know, be physically with our friends. I miss them, and sometimes I think maybe I take them for granted and what they give to me in terms of friendship and support and love. So today I thank God for my friends and ask that I never take them for granted. And I know these past weeks we have been talking about saints who are friends of Jesus. And they can be our heroes. They can show us the way of how to live and how to live as a friend of Jesus. And today, Rev Kev wants to talk about one of those very special friends of Jesus whose feast day we celebrated yesterday.
Absolutely, yes. So, first of all, I want to thank our eighth graders who did a great job presenting about their class saints, and I look forward to hearing about more of those in the coming weeks. But one of the saints that I want to share about, a saint who is very near and dear to my heart, who has helped to kind of shape how I relate to Jesus just by her example, is Saint Catherine of Siena. Yesterday we celebrated her feast day. Now Saint Catherine, that's spelled with a C, that's Nurse Lobo's patron saint, so a big shout out to Nurse Lobo as well. But Saint Catherine, she was a really special saint because, you know, she always had this fire of love for Jesus that always kind of fueled her actions, that fueled the way that she would respond to the challenges of her day. You know, she faced difficult situations just like we're facing some pretty difficult times right now. But she always faced them by saying, what is Jesus asking of me? How is He asking me to love in this situation? One of the great quotes that is attributed to Saint Catherine of Siena is, if you are who you are meant to be, you will set the world on fire. Now, she's not talking about lighting things on fire. She's talking about letting the world see the light of our love, letting the world see the light, the fire of our charity. And so one of the great things that we can do is show the world some light during this time of challenge, this time of a little bit of darkness in our world, to be able to let our lights shine so brightly that they help others. Now, one action item for each of you. I know you might be getting a little bit restless. It might be time to try and do some good works, some acts of charity, to show how much we love others. And as Monsignor was mentioning, you know, it's important to reach out to our friends. You know, not just those who we might be in classes with, not just those who we might know socially, but to reach out to all of our friends. And there are some friends of ours who are in nursing homes, who are in senior care facilities, some of the elderly, who could really use our love and our support during this time. So you'll find included with this video message a beautiful opportunity to write letters to senior citizens who are in nursing care facilities or in senior care facilities, to be able to write to them just to ask them how they're doing, to assure them of your prayers and your love for them, really a way of reaching out and letting our light shine for our friends who are in need during this time.
What a great project. And so as we bring to conclusion our time together today, and before I say a prayer, always remember that you're a cathedral kid. You're here at the school of the cathedral so that you can become that person that God created you to be. So let us pray. Father, we thank you for the gift of our friends, and we ask you today to give us all we need that we might be good friends to others. May we never take our friends' love for granted. May we always try to support them in good times and bad, and help us always be mindful of those who cannot get to their friends and those whose friends are few. May we be a sign of your love and your fondness for all people. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Hey, have a good day, and we still look forward to seeing you one day soon around the cathedral. And and you're in our thoughts and prayers every day.